Hey, good morning, friends. Sunday morning. Thanks for tuning into the podcast. Welcome to the Deep Things of God with Brother Mike. This is podcast number 8. Territorial spiritual warfare in the heavenlies. Teaching today. I just want to share a few interesting things about this new concept that's sweeping through the deliverance ministries all over the country. I got some red flags here. You can watch this podcast, of course, every Sunday morning at 9 o'clock Mountain Time. It'll be 8 p.m. Pacific, 11 o'clock in the morning on the East Coast. And you can watch it live on twitch.tv. All you do is put in the code HCCADC, and then you can watch it live on my Facebook page, Michael W. Smith. Every Sunday morning at 9 o'clock. Thanks for tuning in. I'll see you next month in Carlsbad, California for a healing and deliverance Christmas Eve service. Go to the website, hardcorechristianity.com, and catch the address and the times off the website. Also, please remember, I will be in February. I'll be in Emporia, Kansas at the VFW. That's also on the website. Please remember now that we have two Zoom deliverance and healing services every week, Tuesdays and Wednesday nights at 6 p.m. Mountain Time. And we have two live services every week, Thursdays and Friday nights at 7 o'clock Mountain Time at the Arizona Deliverance Center in Phoenix. We're downtown on 15th Avenue, just south of Osborn Road. It's a red brick building. Also, 7 days a week, you can catch my local radio show in Arizona. The times you can catch it are on the homepage of the website, down at the bottom left corner. My main radio program is on every morning at 7:30, Monday through Friday, on KXXT Christian Radio. You can also check out off the website my archive radio shows. Now, the radio shows are a little different. They've got kind of a very edgy sense to them. They're not like regular Bible studies like I do on the podcast. So some of the radio shows are a little bit R-rated. So, they're not for everybody. But what I'm trying to do there is explain the truth in as raw a form as I can present it. I do the best I can. Every day I'm on the radio locally here in Arizona, the Phoenix area, Maricopa County, KXXT 1010 AM radio. As I mentioned to you on a previous podcast, many years ago I did a radio show on deliverance. This was like 2006 or 7, something like that. I can't remember the year I did it. And God spoke to my heart and told me that someday the deliverance was going to be everywhere. Casting out demons was going to be a common thing. And I thought I was just hearing myself say it, because at that time, back in 2007 or what have you, that didn't even look like a possibility. And within a few months after I got that thought in my head, it was a year or two later, and it was starting to happen. And now, exactly what I did that radio program on is exactly what's happening. Deliverance is all over the place. Most of it's bad. Okay? Any deliverance program that you get involved in that is not based on repentance, that's the bullseye, repentance. Repenting of sin, repenting of iniquity in the heart, and renewing the mind. Any deliverance program you get involved in that doesn't have that, that just spends its time casting out demons and having people flop around in parks and people puke all over the sidewalk and people running out and, lifting cars up and throwing them around, any kind of major manifestation deliverance program that you get involved in that is not repentance based, that program will eventually do more harm to that person than they will good. Because in Matthew 12 and Luke 11, the Bible teaches, or Jesus taught, that when a spirit goes out, when he comes back, he'll bring reinforcements. And to quote Jesus, quote, the last state of the man is worse than the first. That's something you and I don't want to do. You know, you have a good heart and you care about people and you want to help them. And the last thing you want to do is hurt them. And so it's fun casting demons out, so to speak. You get likes and clicks on your YouTube stuff and everything. Social media looks great. Oh, you're having a bang up time. You're casting demons out of somebody on the street. And boy, there's a lot of that going on, isn't there? Yeah, because we have a homeless and mental illness crisis in the United States. Nobody wants to do anything about it. All these sick people are just living out in tent communities. So yeah, you can go out there and you can find people loaded with demons up and down the street. Bad demons. And what those demons are doing, they're just kind of accommodating you. They're saying, well, hey, these church people, I'm going to give them a good show today. So you got some guy roaring, you got some gal screaming, you got people doing cartwheels. It's a big show. You get the likes, you get the clicks. That is not going to help those people. Those demons, if you do get demons out of them, they're simply going to come right back. And because the person hasn't renewed their mind, they haven't repented, and they haven't changed the iniquity in their heart, those demons get right back in. And the last state of the man or the woman is worse than the first. Well, in addition to that, showboat deliverances, in addition to that, we now have the false doctrine of territorial spiritual warfare. Warfare in the heavenlies. Fighting demons in the heavenlies. Oh, my Lord, you got to be kidding me. It's happening all over the place. And people are being enormously hurt by this false teaching. This thing is extremely dangerous. Now, let me give you just a simple illustration. You go to Luke chapter 10 and you go to verse 19. Everybody uses this verse, don't they? I use it all the time. Behold, I give you power to tread on serpents and scorpions and over all the power of the enemy. Nothing shall by any means hurt you. The Greek word for power there is exousia. It means authority. I give you authority, okay, over scorpions and serpents. And in addition to that, over all the power. Now, that's not the same Greek word, exousia. This is the Greek word dunamis, supernatural power of the enemy. And nothing shall by any means hurt you. Okay? Now, people use that verse all the time to attack demons over Phoenix running all the YMCAs. They attack the demons over Las Vegas running prostitution. There's a never-ending list of demons to attack, principalities and powers way up there destroying the United States. They're all real and they're all destroying the country, 100%. But you cannot take a verse out of context when you're studying the Word of God. You cannot do that. If you do that, you're going to get in big trouble. And territorial warriors are getting in big trouble. I've been a counselor for 40 years. People come to me all the time for counseling. Preachers, ministers, pastors, TV preachers, evangelists, you name it. I've seen all kinds of people. And people come to me sick and they need deliverance and they're infected with demons. And these territorial warriors are coming to me trying to get delivered from demons. They are sicker than you can believe. And the reason for that is because they've been doing territorial spiritual warfare. When you attack the demons in the heavenlies, not the ones down here, but the ones up there, when you do that, they notice it. they notice it and they come for you. They come looking for you. And let me tell you something, it's not a pretty sight. But that verse I just read to you, Luke 10:19, is one everybody uses. The territorial warriors use it. And it is false. The context of the text of Scripture is the most important thing. And that's how prosperities fool everybody. And they milk them out of their inheritance so they can drive a limousine and live in a mansion while you are on food stamps. That's how they do it. They're fake. They're liars. They're frauds. They're con artists. Taking a verse out of context allows you to manipulate that verse to your greed-ridden, lust-ridden ends. And that is not how you read God's word. So let's look at it in context. In chapter 10, as you will recall, Jesus sent out 70 of his preachers. They were disciples in training, and Jesus was providing training for them. He sent them out two by two so they could support one another. Okay? He had already sent out, he had already previously sent out the disciples two by two. And he told them to spread the gospel. At that time, what was the gospel? Salvation, healing, deliverance, the whole nine yards. Okay? He sent them out to preach the gospel. The Greek word is euangelion. It means glorious good news. Okay? What was that good news for? Territorial warfare? No, he went to each of the cities and he went to each of the families. And he said, if the family lets you in the home, let your blessing stay with that family in that home. If you come into the home, you're worthy of your labor. So eat what they put in front of you. Okay. And then when you're done there, move to the next house. Now, if that house rejects you, okay, kick the dust off your feet and go to the next house because it'll be more tolerable on judgment day for Sodom and Gomorrah than it will be for that house because that house rejected more truth than Sodom and Gomorrah rejected. Sodom and Gomorrah didn't have the level of truth. They didn't have the gospel. And so their judgment is less. There's degrees of punishment in hell as there are degrees of punishment on the day of judgment. You are responsible for the amount of truth that you receive. That's how the system works. Well, Jesus said, don't let your blessing stay on that house. Just kick the dust off your feet. Go to the next house. Okay? That's the context of this verse. Remember? And then after Jesus said that these cities, Capernaum, Bethsaida, Chorazin, they would be judged more harshly on judgment day than Sodom and Gomorrah will. Because they got more truth and they rejected more truth. Sodom and Gomorrah was a sin-ridden area and it affected all the suburbs to Sodom and Gomorrah. Those were the two main cities. And they had rejected the truth of Jehovah as they knew it. And they were soaked in sin. They were doing everything. It wasn't just homosexuality and pedophilia. They had the whole career going. They were kind of like a precursor to Las Vegas or San Francisco or New Orleans or some wickedly corrupt city like that. Okay? And Jesus said, in hell, it will be worse for these cities now, he said, than it was for Sodom and Gomorrah. And then it says, as you remember, verse 17 to 70, they come back and they're so excited. He said, Lord, even the devils are subject to us through your name. Okay? The Greek word for devils there is daimonion. It's demons. And Jesus said, hold on just a second. Whoa. You guys are off the track. Okay, you got to stop for a second. Now, you think you saw something supernatural that made you happy? Okay, you should have been me. I actually saw Satan fall out of the heavens like lightning. When did that happen? How did it happen? He didn't say. Okay, But his point is, look, you guys saw demons come out of these people and you got all excited about it and happy. I saw Satan himself, the prince of darkness, the ruler of the demons. I saw him cast out of heaven like lightning. I'm not rejoicing in that. And you should not be rejoicing in that. Here's what you need to rejoice to. Even though I gave you power to tread on scorpions and serpents and over all the power of the enemy, that's not the source of your joy. Your source of your joy should be you are in Father's glorious book in heaven. You are born again, you're saved, and your name is written in the Lamb's book of life. Your names are written in heaven. That is your emphasis. Refocus off the demons onto the glories of heaven, and your name is written down in glory. See? It's yours. That's the true joy. Remember that story? Now, what was that verse talking about, 10:19? It was talking about demons they were facing as they spread the gospel on earth, the demons here. You have authority when you preach the gospel to cast demons out of human beings here. If you look at Mark chapter 5, if you look at Mark chapter 7, if you look at Mark chapter 9, you see Jesus casting demons out, of a boy with the deaf and dumb spirit. You see, you see Jesus casting demons out of the Syrian woman's daughter. In Mark chapter 1, you see Jesus casting demons out of a guy in the service whose demon was disrupting the place. He started screaming and yelling, fell down on the floor, started manifesting. If you notice something there, in Luke 13, you saw Jesus cast the spirit of infirmity out of a disabled woman. Do you notice something there? Jesus never did territorial spiritual warfare, nor did he ever tell you to do territorial spiritual warfare. He never told you to do it. He never trained you to do it. He trained us to do warfare here on earth, not the demons in quadrant 2 and 3 in extension 7 in the universe. You're not to be attacking those demons. Why am I telling you this? I have had dozens of people come to me who had their lives destroyed because they were territorial spiritual warriors. Finances gone, health gone, marriage gone, kids gone crazy, laid off, broke. I've seen everything. People get immediately or close thereafter attacked by these territorial demons when they hear and they know that you are attacking them and you don't have any authority to attack them. The Bible doesn't give you any authority anywhere to attack territorial spirits. Or let's try another one, just as an example. Matthew chapter 18, verse 18, Jesus said, "Verily I say to you, whatsoever you bind on earth shall be bound in heaven. Whatever you loose on earth shall be loosed in heaven." Remember that? Now, that verse is very interesting. What's the context of that text? What is the context of that text? Right. What was Jesus talking about when he said that text? He was talking about one Christian brother trespassing against another Christian brother. He said, if a Christian brother stabs you in the back, go to the person directly. If they don't listen, take a couple people with you. Let them go. If that doesn't work, go to the church board or take the church over there, pastor, what have you. And if the person rebels, like Korah in the Old Testament, if they're rebelling and they won't listen to anybody and they keep stabbing you in the back, that's it. Excommunication. You treat them like a heathen, it says. What is an ethnikos? Yeah, that's a non-national, someone who is not a national, for example, a non-Jewish person who's in Israel. You treat them like a heathen, a non-national. And then you also treat them like you do publicans. A telonis is a publican. It means to be a tax farmer. Publicans were hated in Israel because they worked for the Romans. They skimmed money from the taxes. They gave your money to the Romans, and everybody hated them. Nobody wanted to be around them. Their families even disowned them. The only people that liked tax collectors were other tax collectors, or technically tax farmers. Then he says, whatever you bind on earth shall be bound in heaven. Uranos is the Greek word for heaven. That's heaven, heaven, where Jesus lives. Where Jehovah's throne is, Uranos. It's not the Greek word Epiranios, which means the atmosphere, the heavenly atmosphere around the earth, like you would see in Ephesians chapter 6. What's this verse saying? He's talking about dealing with people here on the earth, not doing territorial or spiritual warfare. You cannot take a verse out of context and then throw it against the wall and hope some of the mud sticks. That's not how this thing works. After he tells them about binding and loosing, which is the authority that you have, again, people, spirits in people around you, in your business, in your church, in your body, in your life, you have authority to attack those spirits. Jesus then says, verse 19, I say to you that if two of you shall agree on earth as touching anything they shall ask, on earth, he said, it shall be done for them of my Father who is in Uranos. Heaven. Father is in Uranos. Heaven, heaven. That's where Father is. Not heaven, Epiranios, the atmosphere around the earth. That's where spirit beings transfer and traffic, in that heaven around the earth. He's talking about heaven in heaven, where God lives. If you guys will agree down here on earth, your heavenly Father will answer your prayers from heaven. For where two or three are gathered together in my name, I am in the midst of them. He's in the midst of us here on this earth, down here, not doing warfare in the heavens. Okay? And the reason I'm teaching this today is because this false doctrine is sweeping the country, and there's a lot of people are going to be destroyed. Prophetics are doing it. They actually have prayer meetings where people get together and war against the demons controlling their city or their state. That's very common now. I'm going to tell you something. These demons heard you do it. They recognize it. And they're going to come for you. And it's going to be ugly. You're going to suddenly see weird illnesses pop up in your body. You're going to suddenly see weird stuff going on with your finances. You're going to lose a job. You're going to have a car accident. Weird stuff's going to start happening. Okay, and that's what God is telling you. Since Jesus didn't do it, you're not doing it. Okay, in the Great Commission, which is found in Matthew 28, Mark 16, Luke 24, those three, the end of those chapters, combine together to make the Great Commission. In none of those chapters did Jesus ever tell you to follow my example and do territorial spiritual warfare. It never happened. Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John, Acts, no one ever did territorial spiritual warfare. Okay. Your job is here on this earth. Your job is your body, the lust of your flesh, the pride of your life, the lust of your eyes, demons in your body, demons in your family members' bodies, demons attacking your church, demons in your church, not the demons running around Las Vegas building a new casino. Okay, that is not within your purvey of authority. You don't have that authority. And if you violate it, the demons are going to retaliate. I've seen it over and over again. I've been doing this for years. I've been a counselor for 40 years. Now listen, I know more than 99% of all Christians. Why? Because I'm a counselor and people tell me their deep, dark secrets. That's the point of having a counselor. A therapist, a psychologist, someone who intimately is involved with your life. That's the purpose of the profession. People tell me things they would never tell a family member or a friend or anybody else. Okay? I get the inside scoop on everything. Mega churches, families, marriages, all of it. It all comes in. I know what I'm talking about. People have been attacked like you can't believe. Last week, I believe it was last Saturday, I was at the International Healing Cathedral in Sunny Slope, Arizona, in North Phoenix. And I had a short teaching on my experience with Sunny Slope involving my daughter. Then another person got up. His name was Pete. He gave a testimony about his experience when he came to that church years ago when he was a crack addict. And then one of my counselors, Julie Andrews, got up and she gave a testimony about how her life had been destroyed because of Sunny Slope. She had gone over to a mountain in Sunny Slope, which was kind of across the street from where the church was. And she had gone up there and she was doing territorial warfare over against the demons, bringing in all the drugs and everything else into Sunny Slope. Because at one time, Sunny Slope, Arizona was the meth capital of the world, or at least America. Well, if you wanted meth, you got it in Sunny Slope. So she was doing spiritual warfare. And very shortly after that, within weeks or so, her life fell completely apart. Her relationships blew up. Her finances exploded. And she said it went on for like 15 years or something. If you go to my YouTube channel, youtube.com/houseofhealingaz, that service is on YouTube. And we had some remarkable deliverances that day. We had a very low turnout, unfortunately, but the deliverances were like off the hook. Her life was destroyed because she did territorial warfare and she was spiritually ignorant. You don't get a pass in the spirit world if you are spiritually ignorant. If you're stupid, you don't get a pass. They don't know what they're doing. My goodness. The devil says, well, I'm gonna give them a break. I'm gonna tell the demons just to kind of pass over them. Are you kidding me? He'll take any advantage over you he possibly can, including your ignorance. You roll out of bed an ignorant, asinine, imbecilic, moronic fool, the devil will make sure you die like that. You are not going to get a pass. You don't get any special covering from God. You get nothing. Jesus did not put people in ministries until he trained them first. And that scripture I read to you, Luke 10, Luke 9, Matthew 9, Jesus sent them out to train them to spread the gospel, heal the sick, raise the dead, cast out demons, freely receive, freely give. And then at the end, in the Great Commission, Jesus said, teach everyone to do everything I commanded you. The church has failed America, and now Satan is taking us down the toilet. America is lost. Our job is to pull them out of the fire and save as many as we possibly can. Your authority over demons only relates to you your environment, your family, your surroundings here on earth. You do not have authority to cast demons out of the skies above Antarctica. I command you, spirit, I command you, eat a bowl of ice and leave. You don't have that authority to do that. Okay? Behold, I give you power to tread on scorpions and serpents and over all the power of the enemy. All is taken in context. All does not include authority over Satan's power in hell. I do not have the authority. In the name of Jesus, I command Satan to wear a cowboy hat, put on a tutu, and sit in a pile of coals right now. In Jesus' name, go. I don't have authority to do that. You only have authority where it's been given to you specifically by the Lord. You have authority to heal the sick. You have authority to cast out demons. Not out of the heavenlies or out of Saturn or Jupiter. Whatever demons are there, I don't know and don't care. They're there. That's their business. They're not. That's not my business. I don't give a rat's fanny what demons are in Pluto. I don't care what demons are running Saudi Arabia. You cannot cast demons that are running Saudi Arabia out of Saudi Arabia. You don't have that authority. Jesus never did it. And if you step out of your authority area in any field, okay? Not just healing, not just deliverance, anything, finances, any authority that you have. If you step out of that authority, the devil's going to bring a hammer down on you. He's going to hurt you real bad. And it's going to be embarrassing. And it's going to hurt. And you're going to lose your health, your finances, and everything else. Stop doing it and stop doing it now. Cancel your prayer meetings, casting demons out of Maricopa County. I command all the demons to leave and move to New Jersey. Okay, first of all, the demons aren't going to leave because they don't want to go to New Jersey. Who wants to go there? Okay, nobody. But you don't have authority to get demons to go to New Jersey, even though they don't want to go. Okay, you're not going there either, are you? You don't want to go. Stop it right now. Do not do this anymore. Please. I have seen too many people with broken hearts in my office in tears because they took it upon themselves to attack someone they didn't have the authority to attack. Okay. When I was in junior high, I started boxing. I was a welterweight back then. I was in eighth grade. I loved boxing and I was absolutely addicted to it. And I trained every day after school, every day after work, every chance I got. I got on a local boxing team. And the guy that ran the club was named Joey. And he would take us to Santa Ana. I lived in Anaheim. And we would go to the Santa Ana to the 4th Street Gym. And this 4th Street Gym was loaded with Hispanics and Mexicans. I was the only white guy there. I was the only white guy in miles. It didn't take me long to figure out that at my boxing club, where I was pretty good, and people thought, boy, Brother Mike's a pretty good fighter. It didn't take me long to realize that when I got to the 4th Street Gym in Santa Ana, I was not a good fighter. Okay, the pros there who couldn't afford sparring partners, the guys that were, 5-0 and 7-1 and 12-2, those guys, they needed sparring partners. Guess who they used? Now, let's use this tall white kid over here. I didn't have the ability to beat fighters of that caliber, I learned there was a hierarchy, skill level. Okay? And later on, of course, I learned that hierarchy went all the way up to world champion class fighters, Pan Am Games, Olympics, professionals, championship professionals, super fighters, and then all the way up to a guy named Sugar Ray Robinson from Chicago. He was at the top. So there's always a hierarchy, and I didn't have any skill level or authority to go above my skill level, skill set, and fight those kind of fighters. I would have gotten killed. If you go above your skill level and you try to do things that Jesus himself didn't do, if you try to do things that Jesus never taught anybody to do, if you try to do things that you think should be done because some cooked out prophetic or crackpot charismatic got an idea, they read a book called Territorial Warfare, then they read another book called Courts of Heaven, and you're going to go to the courts of heaven and get authority to attack, you know, stop. Cut it before it's too late. I'm doing this Bible study because I care about you and I don't want you hurt. You can contact me at mike@hardcorechristianity.com. Please go to the website. Thank you for all your donations for 2022. It was fantastic. We paid all of our bills on time and had money left over. Gracias. Don't forget about our services. Two Zooms, Tuesday, Wednesday. Two live services, Thursday, Friday. 6 o'clock, 7 o'clock p.m., respectively, Mountain Time. Behold, I give you power to tread on scorpions and serpents and over all the power of the enemy. Nothing will by any means hurt you. If you read that verse in context, if you don't, and you apply that to everything, you are going to get hurt. You're going to get hurt real bad. You're going to be sending me an email. And I'll help you. I get it. You might even call me, 602-636-5800. If you live in the Phoenix area, you're a born-again Christian, and you need counseling, you don't have any money to pay for it, 602-636-5800. We provide free counseling services to people who have no insurance and who are impoverished, so to speak. Okay. See you next time.